Hey guys, congratulations on making past the first module. So, now you know how to perform the basic configuration of KWHotel 3, you know how to assign rooms to room groups, you know why room groups are so important, and right now, we will be moving to rate plans, and how they can greatly boost your efficiency and revenue. So, as always, I have prepared a short presentation. Let's go. The first advantage of having the rate plans module used in your property is that it causes your receptionists to make far less mistakes. Why is it so? Because the prices will be loaded automatically. If you think about it, having to browse through billions of spreadsheets while your customer is waiting on the phone doesn't really sound like a peaceful situation. Instead, everything will happen automatically. No calculations are required on your side, which also greatly speeds up the guest service. And it gives you more choices for your guests. In the standard or pro version, you can have multiple rate plans as opposed to one that you can have in the free version. So, for example, you can have breakfast included, no breakfast, etc. So, your guests may not agree for a breakfast included option, but the second one will be appealing to him, and boom, you have the reservation. And the last but not least, it allows you to use the so-called dynamic price policy. What is it? Basically, if you set different rates for every single day, for every single room group in your property, you can boost your revenue by up to 10 times, which is huge. So, for example, if you have less reservations during a specific period, you lower the price to keep the momentum going, to keep the reservations coming. But during the high season, you can greatly raise the price and the room will sell anyway. If you want to learn more about revenue management like a pro, wait for this advertisement. 10 times more revenue thanks to dynamic price policy? Honestly, it blew my mind away. And this is just one out of hundreds of tips and insights that will be a part of our Hotel Revenue Master course. It's been created by my good colleague Julia Armatis, who has over 10 years of experience in hotel management and restaurant management. What's even better, she teamed up with a high-end hotel revenue manager to give you knowledge about revenue management you won't find anywhere else online. So when the course is released, I will pin it up here to this video. And I can't wait to see the final results by Julia, and I hope you feel the same vibes. And in the meantime, let's get back to business. Thank you so much for bearing up with me through this message. As you could see, as you could tell, I'm really excited about this project, but right now we have to get back to rate plans, get back to KWHotel 3, and we will be doing it. So, in KWHotel 3, I click the rate plans module, and here, by default, you will see the standard rate plan, but let's erase it, because I want to show you the process of creating a rate plan from the scratch. So, the rate plan is erased, we click Add, and this causes the rate plan wizard to come up. We click Next, and here we need to come up with the name. So I'll do the standard rate plan again. These three options, you don't have to worry about them, at least here in the free version. But if you would have the pro version and you would be using the KWHotel booking engine, for example, this is one of the configuration options it gives you. But I'll not dwell into details right now. Let's click Next. If you want this rate plan to be breakfast included, for example, you can do it here. This will cause the meal to be automatically applied to the reservation. Now let's click Next. If you want to apply minimum length of stay or maximum length of stay, you can do it here. It's called restrictions. And it also is used if you have synchronization with online booking portals, for example, booking.com. It is also used there. Let's click Next. Now, if you want a specific room rate tax to be used for this particular rate plan, you can do it here. I'll just leave it to zero, as I mentioned in the second video, I think, of this tutorial, so the basic configuration. I mentioned that you have always, when you set up the taxes, prices are always tax included. If you want to add the room tax on top of the room rate, I'll show it in one of the future videos. So in this room tax field, if you set it up to, for example, 10%, it means that this rate plan will apply a 10% tax, which will be included in the price, okay? So I make it 0, not 100, I'll make it 0. Now, the reservation border color, what does it do is that if you have a reservation on the calendar and this reservation is governed by a specific rate plan, it will receive a border color. I'll show it later, so let's make it red so that it stands out. Okay, this is red. The display order doesn't matter because in the free version you only have a single rate plan. If you would have the standard or pro version, multiple rate plans, and you want a specific rate plan to be visible on top because it's, for example, the most used one by your receptionists, you can do it here. Right now we click Next, and we get to the validity periods option. So validity periods mean that you can specify when your rate plan is valid. So if you would have the standard or pro version and multiple rate plans, some of them, for example, may be applicable on you during the New Year's Eve or during the, let's say, low season, high season, and so on. So in the free version, you create a single rate plan, so it can be valid for the whole year, for example, or during the season that you are opened, okay? So let's assume we are open the whole year, we have a single validity period. So you don't have to name it. I'll just use the today's date, the 6th of May, and I'll put it 1 year ahead at the end of May. Let it end by the end of the May. We click Save, and we hit Next. And this is the first part of creating the rate plan, just making the name, coming up with the tax, coming up with the reservation border color, and the validity period, and that's it. But right now, we will jump into modifying this rate plan. And here, just wait for it. Here, the only part that is important in the free version is the price settings. And we will work on it right now. Okay, guys, before we move on, I just want a short note on my side. This will be a very, very basic tutorial about the price settings menu. If you want to learn in depth about the rate plans module, look in this video. I've made it about 2 years ago, and it covers almost everything you can find in this particular module. So, okay, you've been warned, let's move on. So we click the price settings, and on the left, you can see the room groups you have created for your KW Hotel free version. You can browse between them here. And when you open each of these room groups, you will see the price periods associated with this particular room group. So in this tutorial, we will be creating two different price periods. One will be until the end of this year, and the second one will be until the end of May 2022. Just so that you know how to set up these rates and how to manage them. So you can do it twofold, because you can either use the add periods and prices option, which will create open a wizard window, and this is what we will be doing right now. But if you want to do it faster without opening the wizard, you can just click and hit add. Okay, I've mixed it up. You can click the price wizard if you want the longer route, but you will be guided one by one, step by step. Or if you want to make it faster, you click add periods and prices. And this just opens a short window where you fill in all the details and bam, you are ready. So we will do it with a price wizard, but you can also do it here. So let's click it. Let's click it. We click Next. And first we need to choose the period. So as I mentioned before, this will be until the end of this year. These names are in Polish, of course, the language of your Windows system matters. I have the Polish version, you will have English or any other version. These dates will be displayed in your operating system's language. So I chose the 31st of December and I click Next. Now, if you would like to have different rates for weekend and for weekdays, you can do it here. So for example, if I deselect these weekends, Saturday and Sunday, my price period would only cover from Monday to Friday. And then if I would like to have Saturdays and Sundays covered as well, I would have to create a second price period for the same time, but I would deselect all those days, and instead I'll just mark Saturday and Sunday. I hope this is understandable. So for now, I will not differentiate it. We will mark all days. Okay, and this brings us to the base price window. So let's assume we are all the pros after watching the Julia's course. And now let me explain what these different fields do. So before we start, let me just tell you what is dziecko 1, dziecko 2, dziecko 3. These in English would be child 1, child 2, child 3. And these stand for age groups. So I will show you in one of the future videos how to change these names. You don't have to focus on children here. You can, for example, have children, teenagers, and elder people. So if you differentiate the price depending on the age group, you can do it here. And these names are configured in a different part of the program. I'll show you where is it. So let's just focus not on the names, but on how the field works, okay? So first of all, the base price of a room, it's the price that is like the initial bid, okay, for your guest. So we have 100 euro, and how many people, how many adults are included in this price? So let's say 100 euro for my, let's say for my double room is 100 euro. So if the second person arrives, so my reservation, my people count in the reservation would be above one, how much will this person have to pay additionally? So if I write 50 here, this means that if I have a, let's say, double room and one person is occupying it, this person will pay only 100 euro. But if there's another person coming to with this person, which means two adults, this will change the price of the reservation to 150 euros, okay? And if I would bring a child as well, the price would be, for example, raised by additional 10 euros. So this is how these fields work. This is not actually difficult. If you look at this example, it's pretty straightforward. But if you are not sure about it, you can also watch my video. I'll pin it once again, let's say. You can watch my video about rate plans. It is explained in detail there. And I think I've made some examples there, so it will be even easier for you than after watching just this video. Okay, so we have 100 euro for a single person, for a single adult, and every next person will pay additional 50 euro. Let's click next. Now the wizard asks you if you want to, enable restrictions. So as I said before, this is about the minimum length of stay, the maximum length of stay. I don't want any restrictions here. You can also close all the rooms, and this is very, very useful if you are synchronizing with online booking portals. So if you would like to quickly close a room group for a particular period, you can do it here. And you can actually do it in a few different places, but this is not a place to discuss it. So no restrictions. We click next. Now it asks you if you want this price period to be breakfast included, dinner included, and so on. I don't want it to be breakfast included whatsoever. So I click next. This you can entirely skip because this is only related to the pro version, to the standard versions. Let's click next. And if you want this price to be applicable also to other room groups, you can do it here. But as probably Julia will explain to us in the course, it's not a wise thing to do. So I'll not do it. Let's click next and let's click finish. So as you can see, my price range has been created and it is until the end of this year. And it's for all the days. Now we want to create the second price range, and okay, let's not do it with a price wizard, let's do it here. So we click add periods and prices, and right now let me switch to 2022. Let's switch to January, 1st of January, and let's make it until the end of May. And As you can see, it asks you which days should it be applicable to. So I do not change it at all. Then we create the base price. And again, let's make it 50 for a single person. And every other adult has to pay additional 25 euros. Children are not applicable to this price range. And restrictions will not be applicable. Meals are not applicable. And these are not related to KW Hotel 3, so we skip it. If you'd like to apply this price range to other room groups, you can just open it here, but we probably shouldn't do it. So let's click save. And where is my where is my price range? Well, you have to switch the year here. So we click it here and your room rate is here. So that's one option I wanted to discuss. And the second one is more in line with what Julia will have to say in the course. It is about prices per day. Because as you can see here, we are talking about multiple days in just a single table. But what about if we want to change the price, for example, only for tomorrow? Instead of creating a single rate for just a single day, which would really be very, very mundane task, and since KW Hotel is all about saving your time and automating your hotel work, it shouldn't be done like that. So here you have the option of, let me just change it, prices per day. And here, this is your perfect way to quickly change the price. So I mentioned yesterday, yes, so we have 2021, we have May, and tomorrow it is the 7th of May, so this is here. And I just double click it. I change the price, for example, 120, because I want to raise the price, because my revenue forecast shows me that I should do it. And here it is. And when, and you can save the changes. Let's just check. And as you can see, this is the single day, the single price range I have edited. I have added. And you can do it like that. So this is all you have to know for the free version's sake. And as I said, you can always watch the video. So, well, I'll have to pin it like 3 times in this video right now. Okay, and in the next video, I'll show you where to quickly display the prices you have just created in the rate plans module so that you can very, very quickly assist your receptionist when he receives a phone call. So see you soon.